Good afternoon, everybody. I'm very happy to present you the result of a survey we conducted last November and December among the slum in Calais, among refugees. In 2015, Europe was hit by what we called the migrant crisis. In this year, a rising number of refugees made the journey to the European Union to seek for asylum. It is the largest displacement of people since World War II. So, Calais is a city of 70,000 inhabitants in northern France, separated by 30 kilometers from the British shores. Unemployment and poverty are high in this area of France. So, a quick chronology of events led to the creation of this slum in Calais. In 2002, the Sangatte Center, which was hosting refugees fleeing war in Kosovo, was closed. This forced the refugees to break up in settlement across larger territory around Calais. In March 2015, the French government opened a center called Centre Jules Ferry for women and children and tolerated the illegal settlement of makeshift shelters around this center, which became known as the Jungle. In September 2015, MSF France joined other associations already in place to help with waste management and to offer medical care. In December 2015, they opened an OPD, offered medical care and psychological assistance. So as you can see on this picture, the jungle, the jungle is separated, a highway separates the jungle here from the port here. The jungle is 50 hectares and is separated 7 kilometers from the downtown Calais and 4 kilometers from the channel. The population multiplied fourfold rise from around 1,500 in early summer to 6,000 in October. The living conditions are very tough in this shanty town. Sanitary are below standard. This is happening in France. There were 90 latrines in total for 6,000 people. 66 were built by MSF. There were 60 showers. People had to queue to have a chance to have a shower and could stay only less than 6 minutes under the shower. An average of 1,800 meals were distributed every day by a French state association called l'Auberge des Migrants. We wanted to assess the health status of refugees and the access to care. We also wanted to describe the journey of the refugees in terms of routes and in terms of violence that they could encounter during the journey. So this survey was difficult to implement. We conducted this survey in November and December. We used the geospatial simple random sampling, and the target sample was 402 individuals. We had to recruit people outside from the camp. It's not what we usually do. Usually we recruit people from the community, but we in France, we were not allowed to recruit people inside the this community because they are not allowed to work. So we had to recruit people who could speak all the languages, the 9 languages that were spoken, the many languages that were spoken in the camp. So in total, finally, we selected 462 individuals. Among them, 425 accepted to participate. 24 refused, and there were 13 that we could not, that we had to exclude because we had nobody, we couldn't find anybody who could speak Tigrinya, which is a language that is spoken in Eritrea. So the demographic is represented in these tables. Men account for 95% of the population. 67.68% were single, and around 60% of them had at least a secondary level education. In this figure, we represented the origin of the respondents. Refugees come mainly from East Africa, Central Asia, and the Middle East. A third of the respondents came from Sudan. The tables on the right shows the distribution of where they come from in their own country. We wanted to know in which area they come from their own country. And we can see that they come from conflict area. 80% of Sudanese come from Darfur, and 78 of Syrians came from Aleppo or Deraa. The earliest date of arrivals dates back to February 2015. There were three more times arrivals of refugees in October than in August. Actually, 77% of the refugees arrived after September. In this map we produced, we wanted to know the main road that were taken. Two main roads were taken. The one from South Sudan, the one from Sudan to Calais via Libya, Mediterranean Sea, Italy, and France. And the other one from Afghanistan via to Calais via Iran, Turkey, Greece, Eastern Europe, Germany, and France. We also wanted to know the travel time to arrive in Calais. So overall, the estimated median total travel time was 100 days. It was longer for people coming from Africa, 399 days. The travel time was not proportional to the number of cross countries. On the table on the right, we represented the median length of stay. And you can see that in Libya, the median length of stay was 180 days, which can explain why people coming from Africa took longer time to arrive in Calais. The medical health problems. Almost two-thirds of people reported they encountered at least one health problem during their journey. Among them, 62.3% had at least one health problem in Calais. Upper respiratory infections were the most frequent pathology, and there was also 6.6% of trauma linked to the fact of when they try to when they jump from high walls to get into a truck to go to England. Overall, access to care was poor along the journey. 39.3% of those who had a health problem in Calais did not have access to health care. About violence. 65.6% of respondents experienced at least one violent act during their journey. Among them, 30% reported at least one violent act in Libya. So the types of violence are represented by country of occurrence are represented in this graph. In Calais, and it was the in Calais, sorry, the most important violent act reported was tear gassing, and in Libya it was assault and battery. Detention was something done in many countries. In this map, we wanted to adjust the violence by time spent in each country. So when we adjust by the amount of time spent in each country, we see that other countries appear to perform violence more. So what was the planned life of refugee? 8.3% of them applied to asylum in the Schengen zone in Europe, and 81.5% planned to go to UK, of whom the half had a family member in the UK. So in general, the population was mostly single men coming from Sudan. There were few Syrians. We guess that they were more interested to go to Germany and not in France, maybe also they get more the asylum status. The length of stay was variable. A lot of people coming from Afghanistan or Iran told us that they spend sometimes one day to cross the Europe country, and sometimes they don't even know the number of countries and which countries they crossed. Refugees, there are minor health problems, but poor access to health. Refugees are fleeing violence in their countries and still experience it during the journey. There is always the possibility of selection and recall bias, but we are confident in our sampling and had a high response rate. We had to exclude the Tigrinya speakers, but a lot of Eritrean people speak Arabic. To our knowledge, is the first quantitative survey among refugees done by MSF, and as far as we know, in Europe. It can bring important data on the condition of refugee travel and a complementary method to qualitative interviews. Similar survey could be done among refugees in Greece and Turkey. Thanks for your attention.